In the space of the beginning was the living word of light. When this world was clearly spoken, all that came was to be right. All creation had a language, words to say what must be said. All day long the heavens whispered, signing words in scarlet red. Some have failed to understand it, so God spoke his final word. On a silent night in Judah's hills, a baby's cry was heard. Glory sang the angel chorus, glory echoed back the night. Love has come to walk among us, Christ the Lord is born this night. All creation sing his praises, now and ever praise his name. All who give come join the chorus, sign the
I've always wondered if I'd been at the stable that night.
Would I have seen a king or just a baby?
If I'd stood there with the shepherds listening to stories about choirs of angels,
would I have asked, what child is this?
Or would I have known that he someday be the shepherd of all?
If I'd watched wise men bring valuable gifts
and kneel down under the guard of heavenly wonders,
would I have understood that he was the one in whom I'd find all wisdom,
and that he was the greatest gift of all?
Just as that baby was held by his mother,
he would hold me.
He would hold me with his amazing grace.
And his adoption by his father Joseph would be a picture of my adoption into God's family.
Who could comprehend that this baby who was defenseless,
swaddled,
and held,
would someday be the one holding me in his hands?
I didn't witness a star moving across the sky,
or scores of angels proclaiming his birth.
But somehow, in the middle of my ordinary world,
this extraordinary baby's birth found a place
in my worn down, beat up heart.
So like all those people who saw him,
he's the one I've been waiting for.
To repair me.
Redeem me.
Love me.
Forgive me.
Comfort me.
Help me.
Die for me.
Raise me to life.
So what child is this?
He's the one who comes to save me.
He's the one who comes to save me.
To save me.
To save me.
He's the one who comes to save me.
Stand with me as we sing together, Joy to the World.
Thank you. also going to sing together, What Child Is This? Thank you.
have said, how could it be?
This time we're going to light the Advent candle, and I'm also going to ask the help of the children to, if they would come up here to the front row and sit down. I'm going to need their help. Whoop, sorry. All right, so children, come up here. Once I find out how many children I have, we'll go from there. Have right down and have a seat. You got 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Let's see here. I got one for you. Now, when I tell you, you're going to bring that up here, okay? Can you do that? One for you. One for you. Somebody want to be Mary? All right. Somebody want to be Joseph? Okay. What else we got? Oh, we got a shepherd. Who wants to be a shepherd? I got more stuff. Want to be a shepherd? Want to do 2? Yeah. Come on, buddy. Have a seat next to your brother. You can help, too. Look, I got animals. Huh? Oh, not the sheep because he's too small. All right. Okay, Mom. Okay, Mom, here. Take the cow.
Moo.
All right. And a horse. Want a horse? No? Okay. How about a horse for you? I got two sheep left. Who wants a sheep? All right. Good. Now, I'm going to light the Advent candle and talk about the story of Jesus and the birth of Jesus. And as I do that, I'm going to ask for the children to come and put their pieces of the nativity set up here. And it doesn't matter where they put them. Hopefully we'll get Mary and Joseph inside, but it doesn't matter. All right. So the first ones that are coming up is everybody who's got a wise man. Who's got a wise man? If you've got a wise man, come on up and place it in or around the nativity, anywhere you want. That's you too, buddy. Come bring him one, just one of them. Let's see. Let's do, nope. That's later. That's a shepherd. Nope, not yet. Hang on to that one. Put that one up here somewhere. All right, there we go. Ta-da! And good job. The people who walked in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in the land of deep darkness, a light will shine. You will enlarge the nation of Israel, and its people will rejoice, and they will rejoice before you, as people rejoice at the harvest, and like the warriors, dividing the plunder. For you will break their yoke of every slavery, and lift every heavy burden from their shoulders, and you will break the oppressive rod, just as you did when you destroyed the army of Midian. The boots of the warrior and the uniforms of the blood-stained by war will all be burned, and they will be your fuel for the fire. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. His government and its peace will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice for the throne of his ancestor David. For all eternity, the passionate commitment of the Lord's heaven's armies will make this happen. Now, who's got the shepherd boy? Got a shepherd? You bring him up here. Place him at the manger scene. Anywhere you want. Put him up there anywhere you want. Anywhere. Doesn't matter. Pick a spot. Bring the cow. Why not? Put him up there. Good job. Excellent. Good job. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. And suddenly the angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring you great joy of all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, in the city of David, and you will recognize him with this sign, and you will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly the angel was joined by the heavenly host of others saying, praising God, "Glory to God in the highest and peace on earth to those whom God has pleased." All right, who's got Joseph? You got Joseph? Okay. Can you put him up there on the manger scene somewhere? All right. Very good. This is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph. But before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, to whom she was engaged, was a righteous man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break off the engagement quietly. As he considered this, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David, the angel said, "Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child with her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you will name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." And all of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet. All right, who's got Mary? All right. On the sixth month, Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, to Galilee, to a virgin named Mary, and she was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman, the Lord is with you." Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think of what the angel could mean. "Don't be afraid, Mary," the angel told her, "for you have been found with favor with God, and you will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus, and he will be very great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him a throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over Israel forever, and his kingdom will never end." Then, who has other animals or sheep or horses or goats or anything left? All right. As we light the Christ candle. From John chapter 1, "In the beginning, the Word already existed, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He came into the world that he created, but the world did not recognize him. He came to his people, and everyone rejected him. But to all who believe in him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. They were reborn, not with a physical birth resulting in a human passion or pain, but the birth that comes from God. So the Word became human and made his home among us. He was full of unfailing love and faithfulness, and we have seen his glory, the glory of the Father, one and only Son, Jesus." At this time, I'm going to ask Aaron to come and sing "Welcome to Our World."
Welcome to our world. Welcome to
sent to heal us, tender brow prepared for thorn, tiny heart whose blood will save us, unto us is born, unto us is born. So wrap our injured flesh around you, breathe out. Sin and make us holy, perfect Son of God, perfect Son of God. Welcome to our world.
So, children, what do we have? We have wise men, we've got Mary, we've got Joseph, we've got shepherd boys, we've got animals, sheep, goats, cows. Are we missing anybody? Are we missing anybody? No? Really? We got Mary and Joseph, and they had a baby named
Jesus.
Okay, do you see Jesus? Are we missing anybody? Who are we missing?
Jesus.
Where is he? You don't know? Oh, my God, secret for you. He's in the sanctuary, hidden, and you get to go find him. Now, he's not behind that building over there, so don't go back there. He's not behind that building over there. Grandpa won't like it if you go over there. Don't go over there. He's not back there at the sound booth either, or the video screens, okay? He's not back there. But he is somewhere in here. So you can go on stage and look around. You can go up and down the pews and look around. So we have a little house light just in case they're looking in the sanctuary. So you get to get up and go find Jesus, just like if you were a wise man searching after the baby, or a shepherd when the angel says, go and find him, right? So you ready? Go. Go find him. Go take a look. Well, that didn't take long. All right. Put him in there. Don't give him to me. All right. Now, parents are all going to kill me because I got a bag of sugar. And they all get some for having fun. So we got a couple for you and some for you. Take two. They're small. And I got some for you. I have no idea what I'm pulling out of here. And I got some for you, and I got some for you. This is better than your fingers, trust me. And I got some for you, and I got some for the big person because he helped. All right. Okay. You can go back and sit at your seat with your mom and dad, okay? Good job. This time I'm going to have Melissa come and sing, Still Her Little Child.
a city filled with strangers, he was still her little child. Though the air was full and the night was cold, she held him close and smiled. But when she laid him in a was still her little child. When the angel called him Savior, he was still her little child. When the wise man gave him treasure, he was still
this time we're going to have communion together as families. And the way we're going to do that is I'm going to bless the elements and pray over them and prepare them, and then you would come at your leisure with your family. Don't everybody rush at one time. Please wait for one family to be finished before another family comes up. We have two stations, one on either side. Cynthia Cook's going to come and help me over here, and I'll be over here on this side. And as you come and prepare your hearts, pray that the Lord will bless us in 2021. And as we remember what Christ has done for us, he came as a child, but he came to give us life and give it to the full. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you and ask that you bless these elements tonight, that as we partake of the bread, signifying your body broken for us, and we partake of the cup, signifying your blood, which was shed for us. May we remember that you did this out of love. You did this so that we might have life eternally with you if we only believe. Lord, prepare our hearts tonight to partake of these elements, remembering your sacrifice, your love. In Jesus' name, amen. this time we're going to have our candlelight service, and I'm going to teach you how to light your candle. And I'm going to have my daughter come help me. In a moment, Jake is going to come, and we're going to sing together Silent Night as we light our candles. But there's a specific way to light the candle. You can get yourself ready. If your candle is below the cup line, it's not going to light. So you need to get the wick above the cup line. Okay, that's step one. Step two is if you have an unlit candle, you do not move. No, I lied. If you have an unlit candle, you receive the light from the lit candle. Okay? You receive the light from the lit candle. So the lit candle always stays upright. The one that bends is the one that is not lit. Okay? Parents, help your children. As we sing Silent Night, the lights will go out, and the only lights that will be on will be the lights of our candles. You can start, Jake.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child.
Last verse, please stand. Thank you. Father, we thank you for your love for us. We thank you that you came, that you lived, you died, and rose again, that we might have life eternal if only we believe. May this Christmas be one that changes lives and touches hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. You may extinguish your light. Thank you for being with us tonight. I hope you enjoyed the service. You are dismissed.
Can I have my communion?
Yes, absolutely. You want me to get my stuff on?